Hello everyone. Today we try to read something very meaningful. It's about poetry. And yeah, so my husband Scott Gardner will read something which is enjoyable about this. So what do you want to read, dear?
I want to read Frederick Schiller's The Division of the World.
Wow, that's a good one. Mm-hmm. Okay, can you start?
Okay, we'll start. The Division of the World. Take thence the world, called Zeus from his high summit to all mankind. Take that which yours should be, as heritage eternal, to you I grant it. Divide it ye, yet brotherly. Then did all the hands to preparations scurry, both young and old, industrious became. The farmer seized the produce from the country, the junker, the hunter, through the woods stocked game. The merchant in his stores had riches hoarded. The abbot chose the noble vintage wine. The king had all the roads and bridges boarded and claimed, "The tithe of all is mine." Quite late, just as division was accomplished, the poet neared. He came from far away. Ah, nothing more remained to be distinguished. A lord o'er everything had sway. Ah, woe is me! For why should I then solely forgotten be? Thy most faithful son! Thus did he make his accusation loudly, and threw himself for Jehovah's high throne. "If thou to dwell in dreamland have decided," replied the god, "then quarrel not with me. Where wert thou then, when I the world divided?" "I was," the poet said, "by thee. Mine eyes did hang on thy expression, upon thy heaven's harmony my ear. Forgive the spirit which by thy reflection enwrapped did lose the earthly sphere." "What can be done?" said Zeus, "for all is given. The crops, the hunt, the markets are no more free. Wouldst thou abide with me within my heaven? Whene'er thou comest, 'twill be open to thee."
Wow. Okay, so could you please tell me what the meaning, the main idea of this poem?
Okay, so the Zeus, or God, is dividing up the world. He's giving everyone a piece of the world that they want. So, he says that, he declares it, and then everyone rushes to seize what is their favorite part of the world.
Oh.
The farmer seizes the country. The hunter stalks game, stalks his prey in the forest. The merchant takes the riches. And the king, the abbot, chooses the wine. The king takes all the money. Okay.
Uh-huh.
And then after that, the poet comes out, and he finds that there's nothing more to be taken. That the entire world has already been divided up and parsed out. And he's angry and says, Am I forgotten, God? What happened?
Mm.
And God says, "Well, you know, what were you doing while I was dividing up the world?" And he says, "I was caught in your glory, and your unbelievable, and the beauty and splendor that is God." And God says, "Well, you know, whatever you want to stay in heaven, you're welcome to it."
Wow. Oh, that's so nice of God.
Mm-hmm.
Help the mankind, everything.
Mm-hmm.
He arranged everything for us.
Mm-hmm.
For the mankind. Thank you, God.
Thank you. Thank you, God.
Thank
and thank you.
And thank you, everything.
And the lesson is that it's okay to be enraptured by poetry and by beauty.
Okay. Yeah, that's fun. Huh?
Okay.
Okay, thank you everyone for listening. Bye.